In this video, we are going over the facial muscles, and I have decapitated friend's head just to be able to give us a little bit of a clearer indication as to what these muscles may look like underneath our skin. So to start with, we are going to have our skull here, and this one right here where you would find it on the forehead is going to be the frontalis muscle. Now the frontalis muscle is on the frontal bone and it is going to elevate the eyebrows. So that's frontalis muscle. And then from there, you see this little purple one. That one is on the nasal bones. So if we have our nasal bones right here, then that has to do something with this region. Therefore, it's going to be our stinky face muscle. You know when you smell something and it like wrinkles your nose? That is what the procerus is going to do. So this purple tape right here is the procerus, which is on the nasal bones. Now right here, these blue ones look like some mean looking eyebrows, right? That is gonna be your corrugator supercilii. And the corrugator supercilii are going to adduct, I don't know if I can really do it. They're gonna adduct your eyebrows. So they're going to bring them together or closer to the midline, as that is what adduction does. Next is going to be around the eye. This is our orbicularis oculi. So oculi, like your binoculars, this is going to help us with closing the eye. Now you have two layers of the orbicularis oculi, and that is a superficial and a deep layer. Go ahead and just do it. So close your eyes very gently. And then if you were to wave your hands right in front of your eyes, you should be able to still see some kind of shadow or the light and then the darkness. That is gonna be the superficial layer. Whereas there's a deep layer, and that's when you're like squinting, you can't see anything. Maybe if it's really light out, you can still see a little bit, but that is gonna be your deeper layer of the orbicularis oculi. Now there's another orbicularis muscle, and that is gonna be around our lips. Orbicularis is just basically circular, and this is where we kind of get the concept of a sphincter. A sphincter is a circular muscle, so we have a circular muscle around our eye, as indicated here with the yellow tape. And then we also have right here, kind of a circular muscle indicated in the blue. That is the orbicularis oris. So when you go and work on your oral hygiene, you can think of oris with oral. So that is your orbicularis oris, and that's gonna be your kissing muscle because it's gonna close your lips. So closing the lips, orbicularis oris. Next, we're gonna have the happiest muscle in our body, and that is our zygomaticus major. The zygomaticus major is indicated as this green one. And if you know the bones, you may recognize it by the name. Zygomaticus major is going to be on the zygomatic bone. And it is the happiest muscle in our body because of the fact that it is going to insert on the corner of our mouth, and it's going to elevate our mouth. So it's gonna let us smile. Now, of course, because you have the happiest muscle in your body, you're gonna have the saddest muscle. And the saddest muscle is this depressor anguli oris. It even sounds depressing. That is gonna be on the inferior portion of your lips. It's gonna attach again at the corner of your mouth, and it's gonna depress it. So it's gonna bring it down, and it's gonna give you a frowny face. The next one right here is this yellow one. This is your thinking muscle. You know when you're like, you're thinking really tough? That's your mentalis. Usually you put like your finger here. If you're like really perplexed about something, you're gonna give it a good thought. That's your mentalis. So it's your mental thinking muscle. And the mentalis is actually going to insert on the skin of your chin. So when you like frown, or if you do any kind of motion, that's going to give you all these dimples here because it's pulling the skin backwards or closer to the bone, which is kind of cool. So that is going to be your mentalis. Okay, now Next, for the more of a superficial muscle, is this one right here. It's a really big muscle. And what I tell my students is that it's massive. And that should be a cue for you because it is the masseter. So the masseter is a massive muscle. Doesn't seem like it for how small it is in this region, but really, truly, it is the most powerful, strongest muscle in your body, not athletic performance-wise, but it is for the sake of how small the muscle is. So it can produce the largest amount of force per square foot that it is, and it is going to help you with clenching on. So it's gonna be able to help you clench those teeth. This is gonna help with mastication. Masseter, mastication. Mastication is simply chewing. The purpose of the masseter is that if we were some kind of animal, let's say a lion, and we were chasing after a gazelle, and that was our lunch, we're gonna bite down, clench, and we're not gonna wanna let go at all. So it's going to really be a strong muscle, so that lunch does not go away. In fact, if you were to clench your jaws, no one would be able to open it. So they cannot pull down if they tried to, unless they tried manipulating it in a different way by tickling you or hitting you, and hopefully that's not happening in the first place. So that is your masseter. It's this massive muscle. Now, underneath or deep to that is this orange one. It's gonna wrap around our alveolar border on the maxilla and the mandible, and then it's going to even be attached in your cheek. And so it's called the raphe, and it's going to be attached there. This muscle is going to give us the fish face. So when you do your fish face selfie, you're gonna think of the buccinator. The buccinator is going to compress your cheeks. So that is the buccinator when you're gonna do a fishy selfie. Lastly is this purple one right here. This is your temporalis. That should be kind of simple for the sake that this is the temporal bone. So you know that the temporal bone is there, and then the temporalis is right on top of it. So it's basically telling you what it is. And then it's going to wrap on underneath the zygomatic arch, as you can see right here. And it's going to attach to the coronoid process of the mandible. So if I were to take the masseter off right here, notice how there's this coronoid process right there of the mandible, and it's going to attach right there, and that's going to help with elevating your jaw, just like you are for mastication or talking. So it's going to help with that. In fact, if you were to be chewing gum or eating or even just talking, gently press your fingers right here on your temporal region and just lower or depress and elevate your jaw. You should be able to feel some movement right here, and that is your temporalis moving. All right, well, that wraps up our facial muscles. Leave a comment, question, concern, anything of the sort. And of course, thanks so much for joining today on our little anatomy lesson on facial muscles. Have a good one.